Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn how to measure the resistance of alternator armature winding. This method is called the armature resistance test or DC resistance test. As you can see here, if there is any machine, induction machine or it is a synchronous machine or alternator, as usually synchronous generator is called, a fully constructed machine has a terminal box through which we can access the terminals of the windings. As shown here, if it is a three-phase machine, then it has three terminals or four terminals for three-phase, four-wire star connected alternator armature windings, and two terminals, positive and negative, for the field winding on the rotor, which is connected to brush and slip ring. So we cannot access any single phase of the three phase winding, so we cannot measure the per phase armature separately. So how to measure it? So we assume that the three phases have resistances RA, RA and RA. Now this field winding of the rotor is represented as shown here, and this three phase winding are represented as coils having resistance RA, which is comprising of armature winding on stator of the motor. Now what do we do? We keep the field windings open and the resistance of alternator per phase is measured by ammeter and voltmeter, or you can also measure by Wheatstone bridge. The alternator should be at rest. Now, as you can see here, I will have only three terminals at the terminal box. So how shall I connect voltmeter and ammeter to calculate the resistance by Ohm's law? So first of all, I will connect a voltmeter with any two terminals, and I will keep one terminal open, and I will connect an ammeter in series with the windings and provide a DC supply. Now the location of the ammeter here is very important, because if you connect this ammeter on the left side of the voltmeter, then this voltmeter will measure the voltage drop across these resistances as well as the voltage drop across the ammeter, which is very less, but still it contributes to some drop in voltage due to the resistance of the ammeter coils. So usually the ammeter is connected on the supply side of the voltmeter. Now we can represent this circuit as shown here, because as you can see that this terminal of armature resistance is remaining open. Okay, so this can be considered as not in the circuit, and so you can remove it from the circuit, and we now only have two resistances, two windings in series, so we can represent it by two resistances in series with each other. So now as you can see in the circuit, the supply will be providing current I, so we can measure this current I and the voltage provided by the supply across these two resistances. So the resistance measured by this method will be 2RA. So by applying Ohm's law in this circuit, we can write 2RA is equal to voltage divided by current, and thus we can calculate the value of RA using this method. Now it is important to note here that this is a DC resistance test. Now when we give AC supply to the alternator, when this alternator will be generating alternating current will be flowing through the windings, and so the resistance in AC condition changes because of the skin effect. So AC resistance is always greater than DC resistance because of skin effect. So what do we do with this value, because it is the DC resistance? Usually it is multiplied by a factor of 1.20 to 1.75, depending on the size of the alternator or the rating of the alternator. Usually 1.25 multiplier is taken to get the actual value of AC resistance. So whatever value we are calculating by the method of supplying DC current to this is multiplied. So actually effective AC resistance will be equal to effective AC resistance RA will be equal to 1.25, or depending on the size, any multiplying factor, multiplied by, I will write here RA1 or RAE. RA. So this value will be multiplied by 1.25. So this is how we calculate the armature resistance. It is the per phase value. It is the resistance of one phase. Okay. And this data is useful in calculating the voltage regulation of the alternator by any method, like synchronous impedance method, zero power factor method, or MMF method, which we will learn in the upcoming videos. Thank you for watching this video.